Are we headed for a summer liquidation sale? Hey everybody, Scott Walters, welcome to the channel. If you're new, I want to thank you for coming. If you're returning, I want to thank you for your continued support. Before we get into today's red hot topic, I'm going to politely ask you to give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, leave me a comment below. I would love to hear from you. Please watch to the end for my final thought. Hit the bell icon so you're notified when new videos are released. It's very important to stay close to the channel in these very tricky times. All right, folks, welcome to the channel. It's always an honor and a privilege to be with you. I hope you're all doing great. Buckle up and strap in. I got a hard hitting pull, no punches, no sugarcoating it, no rainbows and sunshine. I'm just going to give it to you and give it to you straight. And folks, we quite possibly could be headed for a summer liquidation sale in the real estate industry, in the real estate market. Today, we're going to take a little talk about how realistic of a scenario this really is and how this could potentially play out. Listen, friends, like I've said before, our job is to ring the bell and sound the alarm. Hopefully your job is to help me do that. Raise awareness. Let people know this is an artificially created housing bubble due to government stimulus programs and stimulus measures. It has no chance of sustaining itself. It was artificial growth, no organic growth. And friends, the realities are we have never seen anything like this before in our lifetime. We've never, ever seen a housing market behave like this. And the concerning thing about it is exactly what I just said. The behavior of this housing market, what it created, the FOMO, the wealth effect, all this euphoria that was pretty much just placed upon the nation through our government's stimulation measures that they did. And it actually ended up providing what I've said since the beginning, blowback. This has significant blowback that we're seeing play out right now. And the reality is, as we've talked about this before, I've said since the beginning of this channel, since I started ringing the bell and sounding the alarm that this was a real estate bubble, that I will go from buried in buyers to buried in sellers. A flip-flop will occur. It'll go from herd mentality, from buyer herd euphoria to seller herd mentality. And unfortunately for the sellers now, it's not so euphoric anymore at all. People are frustrated. They're mad. I know a lot of us are like, I should have sold my real estate. I should have sold when I had the chance. That is what a lot of people are thinking. And like I've always said, I'm not recession proof. I'm recession insulated though. And I've lived through a housing bubble before. I've suffered the effects of buying in the height of a real estate bubble firsthand myself. The real estate that I currently hold are all income properties bought outside the bubble. And so that's always been my message here. You are not going to get rich buying in a housing bubble. You're probably definitely not going to get rich buying in the biggest bubble ever produced in world history. But you could, in fact, get rich buying outside the bubble. So I think for a lot of us that kind of got on the sidelines as hard as it was and waited this one out and tried to exercise some patience, we're probably going to have our time, our turn. It'll be hard because, like I've said before, when you get into the full swings of a recession, we're at the front end of a recession right now. When we get into the full swings of a recession, most people go into crisis mode again. The last thing on their mind is spending money. For me, firsthand report, just that last night we were going to watch a movie, went to Prime to see what we wanted to watch, and everything, we looked to see what we could get for free on Prime before we bought a movie or rented a movie off of Prime. And I was like, hey, listen, let's just watch this movie because it's free. Recessing, because everybody else is recessing, I'm already starting to think about where I can save money, even though I'm financially fit. But that's just the way people are conditioned. And I know you relate with that. So one of the things we're going to see moving forward, friends, in my opinion, and this is going to be the catalyst to this correction, recession, or depression that's going to take place in the housing market, how we're going to see, in fact, and I've reported on this before, don't be surprised if you see certain areas get to 50% of their original appraised values. This is a very realistic scenario. It happened in the last bubble. We saw other portions of the country get below 50% price reductions in many of the not so good areas in America. All areas will behave differently. Some will be the last to feel a downturn. Some will be the first to rebound in a downturn, but all will feel the effects of this downturn. Why, you ask? I'm about to tell you. So one of the things that's going to happen, I believe, in this coming real estate correction, recession, or depression is once we start seeing the price reductions, the declines, those days on markets, and then eventually job losses and foreclosures. And I believe we're at least a year out from seeing a foreclosure crisis manifest. And as soon as mainstream media gets a hold of it, it'll just accelerate. It'll pour gasoline onto that fire because of our digital diet today. But one of the things I really do believe that's the biggest warning sign, the biggest red flag, are all the homes that were built during the crisis over the past 2 years, because every one of the people that bought those homes bought in the height of a real estate bubble. And so their homes are no longer going to be worth what they paid for them. They will be landlocked. They will not own their home anymore. Their home will in fact own them, because they can no longer sell it for what they paid for it after closing costs, all the fees, everything, and then not to mention having to relocate somewhere else. There's just no chance. These people are stuck in these homes. And then the other thing that's going to happen right now is, because a lot of these developers bought up a lot of land and had a lot of phases of construction scheduled, they've suspended phases of construction, just trying to finish off the ones that they already started. And they're going to have trouble even doing that. Some of these places could, in fact, you could see the street end, some foundations, some fire hydrants, some power lines, but no houses. They will stop. You will live in a neighborhood that shows clear signs that construction has stopped and been suspended. And that's just not a good look for a neighborhood. So then what we're gonna see, if any inventory that they have left right now, they're gonna start offering, like we've talked about, incentives and other things, but mainly it's gonna be price reductions. I wouldn't be surprised by the end of this year, some of these new housing tracts that are sitting on this inventory with investor money, not emotional first-time home buyer money, investor money, they're gonna liquidate. We've talked about how Zillow liquidated a ton of homes at a loss, way ahead of the curve. They were just forward thinking, critical thinking, trying to go back to being a real estate website, getting out of the home buyer space. Somebody in Zillow saw the writing on the wall. These big companies are seeing the same exact thing, and they're doing their best just to get these homes done. They are not building any more new phases of construction at all, unless they're pre-sold, and nobody is buying anything right now. People aren't even buying rental movies off Amazon Prime anymore, right? So you get what I'm saying. People are starting to recess. This is how this one plays out. By the end of summer, I believe you're going to see these new housing developments offer such significant price reductions, incentives, or straight up liquidation and bankruptcies, it's gonna have a spillover effect. So the challenge with this one is, anytime we're doing a comparable market analysis to determine a home's value, we gotta pull area sales. So if we're pulling area sales from these developments that are liquidating homes, that's gonna affect all surrounding areas, and it spreads like a wildfire across the nation. In final thoughts, I come to you as a friend, as a content creator. Somebody wants to see you not only win in real estate, knowing that buying in the height of the biggest real estate bubble probably is not going to provide that. Buying outside the bubble absolutely will. It's going to be very important that we stay close to each other, because, like I said, most people are going to be afraid to enter these markets because everybody's going to be exiting. But we can go back to the coin phrase that Warren Buffett uses: be greedy when others are fearful, fearful when others are greedy. When people are starting to get full of fear, that's when the heavy hitters are going to be entering back into these markets. There's going to be too many homes for them to buy up. There's going to be a lot of opportunity for a lot of us. Start talking to your friends, people that want to invest. Pool some money together, minimize risk, do whatever you can to get your pinky toe in the water. I promise it will pay out. If you appreciate the content, I really want to humbly ask you to give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment below. I would love to hear from you. Social media links are in the description of this video if you'd like to contact me there, along with links to channels I've appeared on. I think you might enjoy it. If you're watching from your television set today, another video should be coming on your screen anytime now with an easy subscribe icon for your convenience. If you're interested in buying or selling real estate here in America, there's an email for you. I have a network of top-rated agents in the nation ready to assist you, and it would be our absolute pleasure to do so. Also, great affiliate links to companies offering you discounts in the description. Feel free to take a look at those as well. As always, thank you for your time today. Please go make it count. I'll see you on the next video.